For those of you who like a nice glass of wine, there's a new wine bar in Minnetonka where you can sample more than 100 selections right then and there from self-service machines. Such a cool idea. You can have a snack there too. Wineside Wine Bar is right next to Top 10 Liquors on Plymouth Road. So maybe you sample something that you like and then you can go buy it next door. How you doing?
Great. How's it going this morning?
Nikki Erpelding. Here with four great wines for the holidays across lots of different price points. And I want to start by saying, what a brilliant idea. I used to go to this place called Papa Joe's in Detroit, visiting my aunt and uncle. And they had hundreds of wines that you could sample while you're shopping. I go, this is the most brilliant thing ever. Yeah, the self-service machines, how do they work?
It's pretty simple. You come visit our host. We ID you, of course, first and make sure you're legal to drink.
Got it. Yep.
And then we ask for a credit card and we make you a wine card to put in the machine. It's kind of
like a wine video game.
Kind of. Yeah. Or, you know, slot machine. So sure. You put that in the blinking slot and then just pick your pour.
One, two, three pours.
Yeah. Don't forget to put your glass under the nozzle.
It's brilliant. It's a brilliant, brilliant idea for people who want to sample multiple different wines. That you don't have to sacrifice a whole bottle just to try it.
Yeah.
What'd you bring for us today?
So I brought a few. I brought a Sauvignon Blanc. Sauvignon Blanc is very popular right now. This one is from Longmeadow Ranch in Napa Valley in Rutherford. A team of ours went out in July and we had a great time. They have a restaurant out there too.
But oh, cool.
It is fantastic.
Here, come and show the label.
Yeah, please.
You got this one, Dino? Can you see the label? No? Yep. Okay, so please tell me about
the
wine.
So. If you like Sauvignon Blanc, this isn't not the New Zealand style. It's not overly grassy, not overly passion fruit, but it is a kiss of grapefruit, lemon curd, citrus. It's really delightful.
Awesome.
Great aromatics.
All right. Should I hit this one?
Yeah, please.
What do you got next then?
So next I've got a rosé. You know, rosé doesn't have to stop in the summertime, and this is a great holiday wine. So very fruity, some guava, white peach. Mm. This is from Provence, Chateau d'Astros. We just love it. So actually this is gonna be going on our happy hour menu coming up soon. And you'll be able to get this for $5 a glass at happy hour.
Which one is this now?
This is the varietal? Chateau d'Astros varietal. Is Mediterranean varietals.
But it's a rosé, you said?
Yes,
okay,
correct.
Cool.
Correct.
All right.
Delicious.
What are the price points of these two whites?
So in the Enomatic or next door. So you can buy them either way. So you can buy them in the system, take a sip, you'll love them, and then go buy them next door. But these are both around $20.
Okay, cool. What else? We got about 90 seconds left, so I want to make sure we get to the reds.
So we've got a Pinotage. So
what is that?
Well, Pinotage is a cross of Cinsault and Pinot Noir. It was genetically crossed at Stellenbosch University, actually in the 1920s, propagated throughout South Africa.
Interesting.
And now it's kind of their signature grape. Okay. But Pinotage is really fun to try a different kind of varietal.
Yeah,
right?
For sure. It's a hybrid.
So, yeah.
Okay. So what does it do to Pinot? Pinot's like kind of earthy and dry. Mm-hmm. And what does it like? Help it out a little bit?
Give it a taste.
Okay. You be the judge, Chris.
Yes.
I don't know what I'm talking about. See that awkward silence? Yeah, it's Pinot-y. It's Pinot-y. It's dry.
Yeah.
It's good, though. It's got a little more sweetness, I think, than normal Pinot.
Well, you know, it's great. This is, Wineside is really fun to just explore. So we have all sorts of different varietals and different labels that you might not ever try.
Yeah.
And so then you can see really what you like. I mean, a lot of people are stuck in a rut. They drink the same wine every day.
Yeah.
And it's so fun to explore. And then have the small bites, have a meal at Wineside.
It's a brilliant idea. What's the last one real quick? We got like 10 seconds.
But. Chateau de Malaget. It's a Gigondas Cru of the Southern Rhone. So Grenache, Syrah, and Mourvèdre has a little bit of spicy element
How'd you
to
know?
It.
It's my favorite.
Really?
Of all wine right there.
Okay.
GSM.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
What they call it? Numbsies. Well, you don't have to watch me indulging into the wine. I think it's a brilliant idea. How's business been so far?
Very good.
Yeah.
Very good. Lots of groups. Groups love to come in.
Awesome.
You know, parties, holiday events.
Awesome.
It's wonderful for that.
Well, listen, thank you so much for the tips. Thank you so much for the ideas. And thank you for giving people like a low price point where they can go and try and sample different wines without having to invest in the bottles.
So, excellent.
It's awesome.
Come join us for happy hour. We just started it.
Awesome. Thank you. Hey, if you missed any of the names of these wines, fear not. It's all on care11.com. Wineside is located right next to Top 10 Liquors on Plymouth Road. That's in Minnetonka. Thanks again. Appreciate
it. Thank you.
Hey, coming up next.